Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to synchronize ServiceNow and Jira using Exalate. Basically, Exalate is a tool that you can use to synchronize issue trackers. We support all the issue trackers in this list, but for this video, we're just going to focus in integrating ServiceNow and Jira. In this video, first I will show you the installation process to get your own Exalate application for ServiceNow and how to create a connection between your ServiceNow and your Jira. And then I will also show you some tips and some nice features of Exalate so you can start synchronizing right away. So the first step will be to go to this website, exalate.com/integrations, and you'll click on ServiceNow. And after you fill out this form, you will get an email like this one with your own Exalate application. So this is just an Exalate app that is run in our own Google Cloud infrastructure. So once you access that, the email will also come with an evaluation license key. So you can copy that. And when you access the node for the first time, it will prompt you to set up your general settings. So this is where you will connect your Exalate application to your actual ServiceNow instance. In this case, we're using this developer ServiceNow instance. So you're going to copy the evaluation license you got in your email, and you're going to set up a proxy user. Just call it admin, give him this password, and then we're going to copy the URL of our ServiceNow instance. All right, so now we can log in to our Exalate application. Okay, and as you can see, we have already set up the general settings, so it's connected to our ServiceNow instance, and we have a proxy user. Now we can start actually synchronizing from ServiceNow to Jira. In the Jira side, we're going to use this red Jira server as example. Exalate is just an add-on from the Atlassian marketplace. So you can go to your manage add-ons page and find new add-ons and look for Exalate issue sync and more. And it's just as easy as installing any other Atlassian plugin. So once you have that set up, you will have this Exalate menu. And as you can see, we have the same options here as we have in the Exalate menu for ServiceNow. So the integration is very similar. Okay, so now we're ready to initiate a connection between our ServiceNow and our Jira. To do that, you will go to your connections tab. This is something that you can do from either side. So you can start the connection from Jira or from ServiceNow. There's no problem, as long as you initiate the connection on one side and then accept it on the other side. So for this video, we're just going to start it from the ServiceNow side. There's two ways you can initiate a connection. Basically, if the Jira that you're connecting to, it could be a Jira server that's behind a firewall. So you can choose the second option where instead of the two instances sending each other HTTP requests every time there's an update that the other side needs to process, in this configuration, the private side, so the one that's behind a firewall, will be doing polling every 20 seconds. So it will know when there's a request that it needs to process, and you don't need to open up any ports or anything. So to the end user, the only difference will be choosing one or the other. The configuration will be the same. In this case, since we're connecting to a public Jira, we're just going to choose the first option. And the next step is we copy and paste the URL of the Jira that we're connecting to. Paste that. Give each site a name. So we're going to say this site is ServiceNow demo to red Jira, and click next, initiate. Now you get an invitation code. So just by clicking that button, you're copying the invitation code and you can click on done. The connection is pending. this is an old connection that I already had, but in your case, you guys should only have one. Now you can go to your Jira, go to your connections page, and this time you click accept invitation and paste the invitation code there. You can click next. And this part about the sync rules template, basically how Exalate transfers information. So how you're going to decide what information you send from ServiceNow and how you interpret that information in Jira. That's via two Groovy scripts. So Groovy is just the scripting language that these scripts are based on. And when it's asking you whether you want a single project default script or advanced, it just means when I receive synchronization from ServiceNow, do I want the corresponding tickets to be created in one single Jira project or in multiple? And it's also not a very important decision at this point because you can always go back and edit your scripts. So it doesn't matter if you want to start out with just a single project. Later on, you can modify your scripts so you map the incoming data into multiple projects instead of only one. For now, we're just going to choose one local project. We're going to say every time I receive synchronization from ServiceNow, we're going to create the tickets in this Reds project in Jira. And confirm that, and that should create the connection. Cool. Okay, the connection has now been created. If I go to the ServiceNow side and refresh it, it should go from pending to active. Let me just delete this old connection. Okay. And now we have just the one connection we just created. Just to let you know a little bit more about how the scripts work, we can go to edit connection, both sides, and you'll see that each side has its own set of scripts. So these are the ServiceNow scripts and these are the Jira scripts. So the reason we have two on each side is because if you're the ServiceNow admin, you want to have autonomy on what information you're going to be sending. And also when you receive information from Jira, how you're going to interpret that information and apply it to your ServiceNow entities. And the same thing for Jira, you're going to be deciding what information from your local Jira issues you'll be sending. And when you receive information from ServiceNow, how you're going to be applying that to your local issues. So you can see by default, we're saying we're mapping everything into the same project, Reds. We're also saying every ticket that gets created will be of issue type bug. And we will apply to those issues the summary, description, labels, comments, and attachments that we receive from ServiceNow. So for example, if you have the use case where you need to synchronize custom fields or statuses or more complicated fields, this is where you would add all that configuration. So on ServiceNow, you would send your fields here. If you're sending incidents, you'll add that into this if statement. If you're using problems, you'll add them here. And in Jira, you will map them to your local fields in your incoming script. For now, we'll just keep the default scripts and show you basic synchronization. And also just to let you know, in ServiceNow, we're supporting the incident, problem, change request, customer case, request item, and also catalog task entities. Let's go back home. Okay. So the idea that we already have a connection between the two issue trackers doesn't mean that the information is going to start flowing back and forth automatically. We actually need to decide when do you want your ServiceNow entities to sync over to Jira. So to do that, we have the triggers. And the triggers are just queries that you can create. So you can, for example, go to your incidents here. Let's say we're going to be synchronizing incidents over to Jira. And an easy way to create a trigger is you create a query. So you can say, for example, we want only the incidents that match the urgency when it is medium. So we run that query. So we want all incidents that have the urgency medium to synchronize. So we can just click in this query, copy it, right click and copy query. And that's an easy way to make sure that you're using the right syntax to create your trigger. So you paste your query here. Let's say urgency equals 2. We choose our connection and we activate that. So this will be constantly looking for that event when incidents are created. If the incident is created with the urgency 2, then Exalate will automatically sync it over to Jira. So let's try that out. Let's create a new incident. Add in short description. And we'll make sure to keep the urgency in medium so it matches the trigger. And we can submit that. So now that we have submitted it, how can you monitor the synchronization, right? You can go to your Exalate menu and you have the sync queue. In the sync queue, let's see if it's created, you'll be able to see all your outgoing and incoming syncs. So this is very useful. Yeah, you can see we have one outgoing sync. So, okay, the status is send request. This is our connection. This is the entity ID. So you know this is the incident we just created. And soon, if you refresh it, you can see, okay, response ready. So it's almost done synchronizing. And it's not there anymore. So it's you can assume that it's synchronized. Another way you can check this is if you go to the entity sync status menu, you can choose your entity type and then paste the ID of your incident in this case. And it will give you this sync panel. So it tells you the status of the synchronization. It also sends you, and it also gives you a link to the issue that was created in Jira. So of course, since we are logged into the Jira, we can see this issue. And as you can see on the Jira side, we also have the same sync status panel, which is linked with the link to the corresponding ServiceNow incident. And we also have the name of the connection that was used to synchronize. And here's the issue. Now, just to show you how the behavior of Exalate is by default bi-directional, this means that any update on either side is going to update its corresponding ticket. So if I add a comment here, I should be able to see it in ServiceNow right after. So if I add a comment, I add that, we should be able to see the sync status go back to in progress. So you can see it's in progress and now it's waiting for remote. This means it's already on the other side. So on ServiceNow. So soon enough, it should be synchronized. Yeah, as you can see, if I go back to my original incident, the comment is here. So that is a basic synchronization with Exalate. In the Exalate menu, you also have the errors tab that is very useful if you are encountering any sort of errors with your scripts. Maybe you had a typo in your script. This will tell you which line the error is on, so you can go back and correct that. And it's great for debugging if there's anything going wrong with your synchronization. Yeah, we also have the cleanup tools that you can use to clean up an issue. So let's say you don't want these issues to be synchronized anymore. You can go to your cleanup tools and type in the entity key, choose your connection and clean it up, and it will stop the synchronization between the two. And you can do the same thing for all the incidents or all the entities of one specific connection. And you can do that on both the ServiceNow and the Jira side. Okay, so that's basically the Exalate lifecycle from installing the add-on on ServiceNow and Jira to initiating a connection and actually synchronizing your information from ServiceNow to Jira and vice versa. I hope this was clear for you and that it was useful for you. Hopefully, Exalate is a good fit for your synchronization needs and you can try this out yourselves. Thank you. Bye-bye.